SQL Database in Fabric has Copilot experiences both inline and in the chat. Learn all about it, see it in action, and learn what's on our roadmap this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Yole, a PM working on the editor for SQL Database in Fabric. Yole, thanks so much for coming back on the show.
Yeah, thank you, Anna.
Awesome. It's great to have you back on the show, and you also not only own the editor, but also own Copilot experiences for SQL Database in Fabric, and that's what we're going to talk about today. And I know everyone's super excited always when you talk about Copilot to understand like what it does and what we're investing in. So can you tell us a little bit more about the Copilot experiences for SQL Database?
Yeah, of course. Last time I talked about the query editor, and basically you'll be able to interact with Copilot within the query editor. And we'll just get started with the high level overview of where you can find these Copilot features and how the experience would look like. So the first location where you'll be able to interact with Copilot is the sidecar chat. You can just kind of think of it as like a chatbot interface where you can like ask it different questions or submit any requests, and it will like reply back to you. So there are two different experiences that we are offering today in the sidecar chat. The first one is the natural language to SQL conversion, which is basically give them like a natural language request, and then it'll help you generate a T-SQL code so you can ask questions like, oh, help me create a table or help me add a column, things like that. And there's also the documentation-based Q&A. So basically, you can ask Copilot questions about your SQL database in Fabric, and it will kind of just like leverage the context of Microsoft Learn documentations and answer your questions accordingly. And the second locations where you will be able to find Copilot is the SQL text editor, again, in the query editor. And there's the inline code completion. So as you're typing your code, it helps you automatically finish the code and or providing different like code suggestions. And there's also two quick actions that we are offering today, which is the fix the query action as well as the explain the code action.
Awesome, cool. Yeah, and I know in our private preview, these have been really popular capabilities, especially the fix and explain have been super popular because it's kind of a new thing that we hadn't seen in other Copilots, at least I hadn't seen them before. And like fixing broken queries is something we all struggle with. and so a Copilot can fix it. It's amazing. So I'd love to take a look if you have something to show us.
Yeah, awesome. Let's get started. And yeah, so this is the query editor if you have never seen it yet. And basically where we are today is kind of this like landing page. And to find Copilot, the first way to like kind of like interact with Copilot is the sidecar chat, and you'll be able to find it in the ribbon on the top. You simply just click the Copilot button, get started, and just type in any request that you may have. And over here, I'm using one of the zero-day prompts to create a table that stores employee data. I even specified like three column names that I wanted. And Copilot will leverage the context of your schema and generate a T-SQL code for you accordingly, along with an explanation of what the code does. And yeah, I feel like this code looks pretty good to me. I'm going to insert it directly into my SQL text editor and run the code to create a new table. And you know, like now I might have another follow-up question. I want to add some sample data to this table. And again, Copilot is able to, based off on your conversation history, to provide a new T-SQL code that kind of like matches your request. So now it has gives me like an insert statement that inserts a few new like rows into my new table. And yeah, this looks pretty good to me. I'm going to run another select statement to double check that, yeah, this code is running correctly. So this is the what I just mentioned, the natural language to SQL skills. And yeah, and if you run it, seems like it is working really great over here. I'm very happy with the results. So what I can do over here is to give it a thumbs up and provide more details about what I like or don't like about the Copilot suggestions, and just to help the team improve the product. And aside from the natural language to SQL skill, there's also the documentation skill that I mentioned. Over here, I'm asking it what data types are available. So Copilot is able to kind of like based off on the Microsoft Learn documentations that we have today and give me a list of data types that are currently supported for SQL databases in Fabric. So yeah, this is the sidecar chat experience. Moving on to GA, we are planning to expand more skills, more DBA skills to help users perform monitoring tasks as well.
Awesome.
Yeah, and now let's take a look at the second location where you'll be able to interact with Copilot, which is the SQL text editor. This is where you actually go in and write and execute your SQL queries. As you can see over here, I do have a partially written code. And as I am typing more, Copilot kind of like reads my existing query and provide me a code suggestion. Yeah, this looks pretty good to me. Seems like it knows that I wanted to retrieve the product with the highest revenue. So I'm going to hit tab and accept the suggestion. And another kind of like bonus feature that we have over here is that you can use dash dash and write down your request in natural language as kind of like a comment format. And after you hit enter, Copilot is also able to leverage that information to create a SQL code for you. So this is the inline code completion feature that we have. And moving on, there's also like two quick actions that I mentioned earlier. I forgot to mention about this. For some people, they might not want the code completion feature at all. Maybe like they're
I can't imagine not wanting it.
But some people, they're probably like really confident about like what they want to write, or they want to save costs or reduce
right.
CUs.
That's true.
So they can always just go into the settings and turn this thing off. So this is totally like optional for people. User have the control to decide that whether they want this or not. Yeah, perfect. And we're just gonna move back to quick actions.
Awesome.
Yeah, so in the toolbar, there are two quick actions, which is the explain query and fix query errors actions over here. Yeah, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to start by using the fix query errors quick actions. I'm going to just create a very simple syntax error with the select keyword. And now, since we have an error message, I can simply just click the quick action and Copilot is able to auto-fix the query for me and even tells me where it fixed the typo. And yeah, seems like it is running pretty successfully right now. And now I'm going to show you the explain query quick actions. So you can either select a part of the code or the entire block of the code and hit the explain query button. And what it will do is that it will provide you an explanation of what your code does. So this is really great for documentations or understanding complex code.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I can see a lot of use cases for this. I mean, also if you get a query from someone else and you don't know what it does, I can see that being super useful.
Yeah, and this is all we have for the demo.
Awesome. Cool. Okay. So I have a couple of questions. I'm super impressed by these capabilities. My first question is, anything special I need to do to get this in my tenant working?
Yeah. So at the recording time, we do require you to have an F64 or P1 or above capacity in order to use Copilot. But, things might change in the future. I'll provide more information in the description below. And another thing that you need to do is that once you make sure you have the right capacity, you also have to reach out to your tenant to make sure that they have enabled Copilot in their admin portal. So let's move on to the next slide. So this is what they're going to see in the tenant settings. So basically, what they need to do is that they have to search Copilot and Azure OpenAI service. And over here, they have to turn on this button over here and make sure that it is applies to the entire organization or just whichever security group that you are in. And however, your capacity geographic region might be outside of the EU data boundary or the US. So you have to do another extra step, which is to enable this settings over here. So it makes sure that the data sent to Azure OpenAI can be processed outside of your capacity's geographic region. So these are the things that you will have to make sure before being able to use Copilot.
Okay. Got it. Makes sense. It seems pretty straightforward, but also I'm sure tenant admins and admins generally appreciate that, they have some insight and control over who gets access to this and when it's on, because it does have cost implications.
Exactly.
My last question to you is around data security, because whenever we talk about Copilot and AI, this is always a topic, right? What is Microsoft doing with my data? Is it safe? Is it secure? So kind of how is this Copilot working?
Yeah, that's a really great question. So your business data is secure. All the Copilot features and Fabric uses the Azure OpenAI service, which is totally controlled by Microsoft. So we're not using your data to train any models, nor is it available to other customers as well. And note that all the data getting processed stayed within your tenant's geographic region as well, unless you explicitly specified that you're allowing the data to be processed outside of their region.
Cool. Awesome. Makes sense. All right, folks, this was a great episode. I learned a lot. Yole, thanks so much for coming on the show. If you like this episode, give it a like, leave us a comment, let us know what you're using Copilot in SQL Database in Fabric for. Like Yole mentioned, we'll put some links in the description so you can stay up to date with what we're doing because we are investing here a lot. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.